För tredje gången ställer den kinesiske konstnären Daiyu Lu ut på Galleri Bergman i Karlstad. Han berättar att han började arbetet med tavlorna för just denna utställning i början av året. Och han valde lotusblomman som ett centralt objekt i bilderna. Lotusblomman står för renhet och anspråkslöshet i den kinesiska kulturen. I samband med utställningen så donerar Daiyu Lu några bilder till Karlstad och de kommer att finnas på Karlstad CCC. På grund av att Daiyu inte kan engelska så är hans son med och tolkar intervjun.
Jag är 12 år. Så jag känner att konsthöjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjhåjh 长的一个过程了。那么我呢，在国内的话呢，我的这个建厂的呢，还是我的大学医化疗法，在中国国内这个比较有影响的。
My father started his career or start his painting work from 12 years old, so it's already more than 40 years experience working on the Chinese water ink painting. He's a professional in the birds and flower paintings in China.
So can you describe the process? What's your inspiration?
你那个讲一讲你的这个灵感的一个过程，作画的一个过程。
作画的过程呢，就是因为这个中国画呢，这个对画家的要求呢比较高，因为这个中国画讲究读万卷书，行万里路，这个它有一个要了解中国的历史，了解一些西方的一些历史，然后要阅读大量的这些方面的一些书籍，然后呢要走遍这种名山大川啊，走遍的世界各地方，然后收集素材，然后中国画讲究厚积薄发，最后这个把它宣耀出来，把它表现出来。
It's more like you have to reading many like books and learning the deep feeling of drawing the paintings. Before he start drawing the paintings, he have to read and to watch some books and exhibitions, and also he have to visit the different like the cities, go to the mountains, go to the field to really feel the nature and to collect more materials. So actually in the Chinese thing, like you have to read 10,000 books and go 10,000 miles, to get your real inspirations before you do your real work.
And you've been in Karlstad, of course, before. What do you think about Karlstad?
你对就是你也来过卡尔萨德了，就是你对卡尔萨德的感觉怎么样？
就是每一次到卡尔萨德来的话呢，每一次呢都有不同的感想，因为第一次来感觉到很新奇。这个卡尔斯特德，特别是瑞典啊，整个这个社会啊，感觉到给我的感觉很安逸， 有点像小说啊，像这个对于我们来讲，像这个这个童话故事一样的，因为这个非常安逸，这个瑞典人啊，喀尔斯达的人都很友善，在他们脸上都洋溢着一种强和，一种友善的一种面部和他们的眼光，以及他们的人文，还有他们对这种生活的这种态度和一种安逸的这种生活，是我们就是比较羡慕的。因为我们那种社会呢，比较节奏比较快，人也多，到了这边来以后呢就很安详。我觉得这个地方是一个写字画画作诗做研究的一个地方，人能静下心来，所以我对这个瑞典，对喀尔斯达特这个一次印象比一次印象要好。
My father said like every time when he came you have a better feeling of Karstar, because like the first time when he came to Karstar, he feel like here is a very quiet and a peaceful town, and now then he was really falling in love with this city, and he find it's really like a good place. You can have your time and to calm down and focus on your work, focus on your thinking, and really can make some true artworks.
Will you come back sometime?
说你下次会不会还来？
肯定的，因为这个呢，这个我感觉到跟喀尔斯达特有点结缘了。如果我以后有更多的时间，我想能在喀尔斯达特能住一段时间，然后跟这些表现一些画一些结合这个瑞典，结合喀尔斯达特的人文情怀的东西，再表现一些那样一种不一样的作品。
Yeah, my father said definitely, and he think it may like a destiny. He think maybe next time he would like to stay here longer, and then he want to create some artworks to using some local elements or local object to make some new paintings.